Sweet. Oh, you're recording.
Smiles on.
Hey guys, and welcome to a very special, I wouldn't call it a bump date, but it's like a pregnancy update fun video about pregnancy
stuff. We
can call
it a bump date.
Okay, I don't know. This is my sister Carly. You may recognize her from one of my other videos where we tell each other that we're pregnant. Actually, that video recently just hit 1 million views, so yeah, it's all awesome. Because of her, because she's so awesome and cute. So we're both expecting babies, and they're less than 2 weeks apart, and we wanted to just do some kind of video to have fun with that, because how often do you and your sister get to have babies 2 weeks apart? So we're gonna do the pregnancy tag, and like, no one tagged me in this, I just found these questions. And so we're gonna go through them and kind of compare our different pregnancies and experiences and things like that.
First question, how many months or weeks? We go by weeks now. A lot of the older
people, we kind of count by weeks.
Always want to know the
month. So we'll see. I don't even know what months would be. Someone asked me that today
we're
and I was like,
we're in our seventh month.
Yeah, we're
no,
seven
eighth.
Months.
Eighth month.
How many weeks are you?
So, I am 34.
She's 34 weeks and I'm 35 weeks.
I'll be 34 weeks.
Oh,
tomorrow.
So you're 33 weeks, because I'm 35 weeks.
Wait, am I 34 and 35 tomorrow? No, yeah. I'm 33, but I'm 34 tomorrow.
So she's 33 and I'm 35 weeks, but it's like not totally even. Mm-hmm. Anyway, second question is, what was our family's reaction to our announcing we were pregnant? I actually have videos of both of those. Just excited. My mom, I think, started crying when she found out that I was pregnant, and everyone's just happy.
Mike's side of the family, my husband's side, was in Nevada when we told them, and so it was really fun. We made a video and showed them, and they were all really excited. No one was really well, I guess they were surprised, but I think people were hoping and expecting us to have children soon.
Yeah. So the gender of our babies is?
Girl.
And a boy.
And so they're going to be best
they're
friends.
They're going to be friends. The next question is, do we want more kids after these kids?
Yes. Many more.
Probably she's not planning on stopping
seven
at one.
More.
She wants a lot of kids. This will be my third child. I'll probably will want more. I probably want like four or five, maybe even six. Who knows? Question number six, what are our biggest cravings?
Mine is ice. Like all day long, every day, I just chew on ice. And we don't have an ice maker, so I make my own ice. And we even bought like these tiny ice cube trays, and I fill those up, and they're really hard to get out of the tray, so I like have to like do this.
It's like your workout.
But I love ice.
I don't know if I have cravings this far into my pregnancy. In the beginning though, I was eating a lot of sweets and a lot of salty. We don't really have cravings that it's like middle of the night, I have to go get some yogurt or whatever.
Yeah, the only thing that I've really craved is ice.
And I've been craving ice
and
this
cereal.
Pregnancy too. I've been chomping on a lot of ice because we do have an ice maker, and so I just chomp on ice all day long. The next question is, what is the best part about being pregnant? It's hard to remember those at this point in mine. I'm so
there's a lot of worse parts.
Yeah, there's lots of worse. Oh, I think maybe we'd agree that one of the best parts is when you can feel the baby and they're wiggling and punching you in the gut, and it feels really weird, but it's just like so amazing to be able to feel them inside.
I also think it's really fun how excited everyone is for you. Like, everyone is excited for you. People like strangers and people that I pass. I'm a piano teacher, so all of my piano students' parents are just so excited. And so that makes the uncomfortable moments a little bit better because people are really happy for you. Names.
The next question is, what's the worst part about being pregnant?
Part.
For me, the worst part of being pregnant is the sleeping right now. My like hips and my knees just like don't know what to do, and I just wake up a lot. I have to go to the bathroom a lot. Like 3 times a night at least I'm up going to the bathroom.
Yeah.
And it's hard to get up to do that. So,
The worst part for me right now is heartburn. I have pretty constant heartburn. But I take medicine, so that helps. And the first part of my pregnancy, I was throwing up a lot, like too much.
Yeah, she
but
really
now
sick.
I'm a lot better.
Next question is, what are the names that we've picked out? We have not picked out like for sure name. We kind of make lists, and then me and Zach, we make lists, and then I usually like to see the baby before we choose the name, so I'll probably wait until the birth to choose a name, maybe even the next day.
And that name, like, or the question of names comes up like every, that's like the
thing
you
ask.
That's
like the number one thing people ask you.
So I should just start making up names.
Yeah.
We don't have a name picked out. We have 3 or 4 that we love, same thing. And we're not going to tell anyone what we choose if we choose one.
Yeah.
Because we're like that. We're those people. So stop asking us.
Next question is, who will be in the labor and delivery room with us?
It's just gonna be, for us, it'll just be Mike and I.
Yeah.
We'll have my parents probably there or come right after, but yeah. It'll just be us.
That's probably good.
And the doctor.
Yeah, and nurses and things like that.
That's
good. For Porter and Piper, but I thought I had a good idea of what I wanted, but by the time it happened, I was just like, everybody, come on in, it's a party. But this time around, I don't want to have anyone in except for me and Zach, but I'm thinking I might let my other sister Katie in, because she lives in Provo with us, and I kind of need someone to hold the camera, because that's a part of my life, and I don't want Zach to have to hold it, so I might make her the camera woman, but I don't know. I'm not sure exactly what I want to do.
Katie would love it.
Yeah.
That'd be really fun.
Yeah, sure. Next question is, what's our birth plan? For me, I'm planning on doing kind of the more, I don't know if this is like popular choice, but I'm just gonna be doing like, going to the hospital, I'll probably get an epidural. I definitely will be getting an epidural if it's like an option. Yeah, kind of just like the generic, let the hospital do what they can for me type of a birth plan.
Yes.
Yeah, no like same. Water births or at home births or.
I have a lot of friends that do natural and that they love it. And I'm afraid if I start researching it that I'm probably gonna convince myself that's what I need to do.
Yeah.
But I would rather be more comfortable than not, so.
Yeah.
We're going
the comfort route.
We are all,
and
about,
the drug route.
All about comfort and drugs.
Okay, the next question is, are we scared about the labor?
Are you scared?
I'm not scared of labor, however, I'm very excited and I'm starting to learn more about it because I'm getting closer, and so I'm starting to think about it more, and maybe I should have been the whole time, but the doctor will probably start teaching me more about it because I don't know anything. Other than the baby's gonna come out and
yeah.
I'm gonna be in a lot of pain.
I am more scared this time because with Porter, I didn't know what to think. With Piper, I was going off of Porter's, which was actually really easy, and Piper's was a lot worse, and so I'm kind of scared this time to see if it's even more worse.
Yeah, and everyone is so different.
Yeah, and so
like,
I'm a little nervous. I feel like I'm wishing I could take...
Our mom says that the hospital experience was like her favorite part. It's like she loved all of her.
She was always excited
kid,
for it.
Like
she had five kids.
Being
so.
In the hospital and you for the most part have, unless there's mm-hmm. I mean, and there's things you don't really tell people until
well,
you.
Well, and this is the thing, you
asked.
Can't go online and like read all
but,
of the horror stories or you will freak yourself out. Because
yeah.
there are a lot of things that can go wrong. I mean, it's and babies are miracles, and so you start reading all these stories of girls, different pregnancy experiences, and you can really freak yourself out. So
be positive.
Like, take classes if you want to take classes. Do your research, but don't look too much into other people's. Not that that was the question, but I don't know. I'm a little nervous, but
well,
I'm okay. The next question is: Are we gonna plan on working after we have the baby? Working
so
mom?
You are.
I have like an at-home job. So I will be working on my computer, probably still doing videos. I'm gonna take a few weeks off, maybe like a month off. But yeah, I plan on continuing. My two babies have been really good with me, like doing at home work things with them around. So yeah, I'm just gonna be doing at home stuff.
I will take a little break. I teach piano. I have a studio that I manage, and so well that I teach at and run. So I think I'll take 2 months off, and then I also teach on Skype, so I can do that from home.
Yeah.
And that's the plan, but I'm flexible if I feel like I can't.
The next question, there's a couple questions about like baby stuff. As far as like taking care of baby, for me, I usually just do the normal, I'd sometimes make, one of the questions was, will you make your own baby food? I love making baby food, I think it's really fun, but it does take a lot of time, so I do a little bit of both. I'll make some, I'll buy some. I'll be using disposable, like purely disposable diapers, but Carly has other plans where that's concerned.
Do. Well, I'm gonna do a mix of cloth diaper and disposable. And I'm not like, I'm doing all disposable, like end of the story, like,
yeah.
But I'm gonna try it and see if I like it. I've just heard, there's a lot of people that I know and people that love cloth diapering. It's very economical and it's green because you're not throwing away thousands thousands of diapers. Yeah.
And I think we're both planning on breastfeeding, so hopefully that goes good. So our last question for today's video is, what are we most excited for and looking forward to for after the baby is born? One of my favorite things is, I mean, there's lots of things to look forward to, but when, like, during the whole birth and delivery, I just love being in the hospital for those like 2 or 3 days that you're in recovery at the hospital. It's just like the most special time to have like you and your husband and your little baby like just tucked away in a corner, and you just get to be together and everyone's taking care of you. I'm not gonna have to like cook or clean or do anything else. Just like they are making me lay down and hold my baby, and that's the best thing ever. So I'm looking forward to that time in the hospital. A lot.
I've been really anticipating being a mother for years, and so I think just the excitement of what that's gonna be like, and it's just such a mystery, and I'm so excited to see her personality. I think that's what I'm most, just because my husband and I, we have so much fun together, and there's so many things I love about him, and we're different, and just like, what is she gonna be like you? Is she gonna be like me? What's she gonna look like? Like, just like this mystery of this little person coming into our lives that's gonna change everything.
Yeah. the mystery of like what the baby looks like and everything like that. Yeah. It's like we can customize like everything in our life right now, like our phones and our homes and our houses and our, you know, diets or whatever, but we can't customize your own baby. They just come the way they come. So the mystery of
there's a lot of things that I'm excited about, but that's been on my mind a lot. Like, what is she gonna be like?
Yeah, it's gonna be so much fun. Anyway, this is an exciting time for us because obviously we're sisters, and I mean, not obviously, we don't really look that similar, but we are sisters.
If I had dark hair, we would look a lot like.
And so yeah, we're really excited. Thanks for watching, you guys, and thanks as always for commenting and being so supportive in my pregnancy updates and videos. It's just really a great positive space to be around, so I thank you guys for that. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
Wait, we have to show them our bump. Our bumps. Here they are. There's our babies.
Mine looks bigger than yours.
Yours is bigger than mine. There's bows because she's a girl.
Yeah, blue for boy, bows for girl.